Hi, I'm Krista Seiden. Today, I'm going to walk you through the reporting interface of Google Analytics to help you understand where things are and take advantage of the reporting and analysis functionality available to you. This video is the first in a new video series all about reporting in Google Analytics. Together, we'll look at how to find answers to your basic questions and how people are finding and interacting with your website or app. We'll kick it off today with an overview of reports in Google Analytics, essentially what you can use each section of the interface for. In the next video, we'll cover acquisition reporting, which is looking at where your users and traffic are coming from. We'll follow that up with website performance and user demographics, e-commerce reporting, and then learn how to troubleshoot some common issues seen in reports. We'll add these and future videos about reporting to one playlist here on YouTube for easy reference down the road. Also, I'll be showing you reports from our demo account, which is a real Google Analytics account for the Google Merchandise Store, and you can get access to view that property through the link in the video's description. If you use the demo account, you can follow along with me, or if you'd prefer, you can look at the same reports in your own Google Analytics property. With that, let's dive into Google Analytics. Here we are in the demo account for the Google Merchandise Store. The Google Merchandise Store is a real store where you can buy Google-branded gear. This is an e-commerce store, so you'll see a lot of monetization reports in this property showing you data about the site interaction and sales. Before we get there, though, let's start by looking at the navigation structure. On the left, we have a two-tiered navigation menu. Let's briefly go through each of these sections now. There's Home, Reports, Explore, and Advertising, and finally, down at the bottom, Admin. When you open Google Analytics, you'll start here in the Home section. This section has a quick overview of everything going on in your analytics property, and it's personalized to you as the user of this property. You can see here we have our snapshot of things like users, event count, conversions, and new users over, in this case, the last 7 days. We have a real-time widget that looks at how many people have interacted with our site in real time. Scrolling down, you see reports that you've recently accessed, suggested reports for you based on your use of other reports in Google Analytics. And down at the bottom, we have insights and recommendations. This is a really cool feature that uses Google intelligence to surface insights and various anomalies to you for you to take a look at. Up at the top, we also have the search bar. This is a great area to get help for questions that you might have, to ask things like how many users came from search in the last 30 days, and get immediate answers from Google Analytics. In this case, you can see I put in that search and it comes up with an answer for me immediately. I can even click that and it opens the insight bar on the right-hand side. I can also use the search bar to ask intelligence questions here at the bottom, such as, on what days do I get the most users? If I click that, it'll open up a report in the right-hand side, showing me that, in this case, it looks like Mondays is the day that I get the most traffic coming to my site. From the home screen, the next section we'll go to is the reports section. This opens up a secondary navigation with all of the reports available in Google Analytics. We'll start in the reports snapshot. Here you can see a high-level overview of everything going on in the property, similar to what we saw on the home screen, but with more detail. And while we're here, let's look at a few other things that you can do from Google Analytics. First, we have the date range picker up in the upper right-hand corner. Here you can see I have a date range selected currently of November 1 to 7, but I could select from a list of predetermined dates such as the last 7 days, the last 28 days, the last 90 days, and more, or on the right-hand side, I can choose my own custom date. Next, we have comparisons. This is a feature that lets you compare one or more data sets. So for example, if I clicked into here and decided to build a comparison, I could do something like compare device category matches desktop and apply that, and then add a new comparison for device category matches mobile. And apply that. When you do, you see we now have three comparisons, all users, our desktop users, and our mobile users. and they're compared across the graph. Not just the graph, but all reports that are available in this snapshot. This would be the same if using a comparison in any other report in the reporting interface. If I want to exit out of here, I can go ahead and close these out to get back to just my all users. And the last thing I wanted to show you here is the ability to find insights. So we can click that, it will open up the insights panel, or share this report. So if I click that and click into share link, it gives me a shareable link that I can send out to other users of this property. If they have access to this property, it will open up the same report that I am looking at when they click the link. After the report snapshot, we have the real-time section. The real-time report is a great way to get insight into what's happening on your site right now. As you can see, it opens up with a map overlay, and if I hover over any one of these bubbles, it will show me how many users are actually interacting with my site from that specific city in this case. I can also scroll through and look at the different cards available here. So, what are some common things that I might want to answer with this report? Well, I can check whether a one-day promotion is driving traffic. So maybe I just launched something today and I want to know if I'm actually getting traffic into our website from that promotion. So what I can see here is users from first source. So let's say that promotion came through an email. Here I have people coming from my email newsletter on the site. If I had something, you know, specifically tagged for that campaign, it would show up here. Another question that I might want to answer is what content on my site is being looked at right now, and maybe I just updated the site, and so I want to make sure that everything's working properly. People are able to load that page or look at that content. I can do that by looking at views by page title and screen name, seeing that, you know, various pages are actually being seen on my website. And I can also see events that are being interacted with. And the last thing I want to show you is this event count by event name card. Now this one is really cool because it's actually interactive, so I can click through it to see more information. So let's say that I have a sale going on my website and I want to see if people are actually adding to cart for that sale. I can come to here, scroll through to find my add to cart event, and when I click in, it will show me the parameters that are being collected with that event. So if I want to know, for example, what page people are adding to cart from, if my sale is on a particular page, I can click through there and see exactly where people are adding to cart from. So that will help me understand if people are interacting with my sale page and adding to cart in real time. After the real-time reports, we'll look at the rest of the default reports available in the reporting UI. Now keep in mind that these might be informed by your business objective selection. So when you set up your property, if you selected certain business objectives, that will inform the reports that are available out of the box here. Here in the Google Merchandise Store account, we can see the default lifecycle and user reports. We'll quickly highlight a few popular reports, but know that we'll go more in depth on these in the next videos in this series. We'll start with the acquisition reports. When we click in here, the first thing we see is the overview report. Now I want to pause for a moment and just talk about the types of reporting templates available in Google Analytics. There are two main ones, an overview report and a detail report. An overview report, as you can see here on the screen, is a report with a bunch of cards going into detail of whatever the topic is, in this case, acquisition. So we see our total users plus our real-time card, but then we see things like our default channel group, session default channel group, Google Ads reporting, and so much more. So every overview report will look very similar to this. Next, we have the details report. And let's look at the user acquisition details report. Now, this is essentially a table report. And it usually comes with one or two charts above that table report, maybe a line graph and a bar graph. But importantly, it's that table down below that looks at your primary dimension. In this case, we're looking at the first user default channel group by a bunch of metrics. So we have new users, engaged sessions, engagement rate, and so on. So this is the structure of reports in Google Analytics to get familiar with. Now, in the case of our acquisition reports, there are two types of acquisition reports in Google Analytics: user acquisition, which looks at the first time a user comes to our site, and traffic acquisition, which looks at the session engagement, so where somebody came from for that particular session. So moving on, we have our engagement section. Now, In this section, we can learn about things like events that are triggered on our website or app, what pages and screens get visits and engagement, where people are landing the first page that they see you when they come to our website, and so much more. So, for example, if we said how many people are coming to a specific page over a time period, over, let's say, the first 7 days of this month, I can go to the pages and screen report and scroll down, and I can see that the homepage has about 25,000 views over the past 7 days. And I can repeat this for any page that I have interest in that I need to report on. Next, we have the monetization section, which is about the data of purchases made on our website. And not just purchases, this is also add to carts and, you know, beginning checkout and so much more when it comes to e-commerce tracking. So if you have questions about which items were viewed on your site or, you know, which items were purchased, which items drove the most revenue for your business, this would be the place you would want to come. Specifically, this e-commerce purchases report, this is going to be one of our detail reports in this section. It looks at item name, but you can break this down by lots of different things for e-commerce reporting. Or you can look at flow reports or funnels for your data, such as the purchase journey report, which is a funnel view of how people are going through your site and purchasing on your website. We also have a retention report, which looks at how we are retaining users over time. Next in the Google Merchandise Store, we have the Search Console reports. Now, the Google Merchandise Store has an integration set up with Search Console. And so there are two reports that are made available here for that integration, the Queries Report and the Search Traffic Landing Page Report. These show us what queries are being asked of Google Search and how those users are coming to our site. And with that, what pages they land on when they actually come from Google Search. If you don't have this section set up already in your Google Analytics account, you can go to the admin section or ask somebody who does have access to do that to set up the Search Console integration so that you can have these reports in your property too. Lastly, we have the user section. And this is really looking at attributes about a user and the demographics and technology that they're using when they come to your site. You can learn about your users this way, such as, you know, what are their demographics and interests. If we go to the demographic details report, this is where we would see a lot of that information, such as what country, city, state they came from, and more. The tech section shows us things like what browser they came from, what device category they're using. So if you had a question such as, what is the most popular device people are using when they come to my site, or are they coming from mobile, or are they coming from desktop, this would be the place to go. Lastly, in this section, we have library. This is where you go if you want to customize the reports that are shown in the left-hand nav. And note that if someone's reports are different from what you see here in the Google Merchandise Store, it's possible that your admin has already made changes to your property and set it up to customize it for your use cases. And that's an overview of your Google Analytics reports. There are a few other sections in Google Analytics that I'll quickly show you so that you're aware of them, but we won't go into depth here today. First is the Explore section, and we get there in the left-hand nav by clicking Explore. This will open up in the Exploration Hub, which shows us a bunch of things. It shows us templates that we can start from, as well as a link to a template gallery, and a list of all of the reports that we already have created in our property. Now, the Explorer section is more of a free-form reporting section, different from the reporting UI, where the reports are already built for you. The Explorer section is typically used for answering specific and advanced questions using very specific techniques, such as a funnel exploration or a path exploration, or looking at cohorts. So if you're looking to visualize how users are flowing through your website, this is where you do something like that. You can also use Explorer to create segments. So you can break down any report by an advanced segment to understand how that segment of users performs in relation to others. This is also a place where you can do interactive data exploration, such as slicing and dicing your data on the fly. Now, we're not going to go into depth on Explore today, but check out the videos from our Analytics Academy courses on Skillshop. There are some lessons there that will teach you how to use Explore, and we'll have more videos coming soon to walk you through using Explore. We'll add the video and the course links in the video's description for your reference. Lastly, there's the advertising section in the left-hand nav. The advertising section is where you'll go to learn how your paid campaigns are performing. You can compare attribution models and understand your channel performance. Now, we won't go into this today, but again, our courses have information about this and we'll share some resources below. So to recap, we have the homepage for an at-a-glance, personalized view of your property. You can then go into reports to find answers to common business questions. You can use Explore to dive deeper into advanced analysis methods and use advertising to assess your paid ad performance. So that's all for your data analysis. Then, to actually make changes to the way your data is collected and organized, you'd go to the admin section. Now, we won't dive into that here today, but know that if you have the right permissions on the property and want to make configuration changes, like adjusting your data collection, creating or editing events, creating or editing audiences, or make changes to the property or account settings, like who has access to your property or what time zone or currency you see, you can go to admin to do those things. Lastly, remember that when you don't know where to go, you can always use search. Click on the search bar at the top of the page to search for reports, ask specific data questions, or query for help. Search is a powerful tool to help you find what you're looking for. And that's it for today. There's your overview of Google Analytics reports. We'll be back tomorrow to start answering your acquisition questions with the user and traffic acquisition reports, to learn about users and new users, and also acquisition terms like campaign, source, medium, and channel, so you can look at and interpret the reports in analytics. So we'll see you back here tomorrow for more. In the meantime, remember we're putting lots of resources in this video's description on YouTube. Thanks for watching.